You set up your company, Saratoga Capital, during the Asian financial crisis. What made you think that your company could succeed when so many others in the region were failing?
I think at that time was a survival mode. Number two, the view that coming out of the crisis, Indonesia will not be like this forever, like when we were in 97-98. 5 to 10 years, while Asia will come out from the crisis, energy will be in high demand. So that was the first call that we made on investments. So now that Indonesia is back on top of investment destinations, and it will be investment grade hopefully next year, it's a product of a commitment and of I think a lot of hard work.
What drives you?
I see all this pretty much paradoxical situations. Number 18 in the size of the economy, number 122 in the ease of doing business. It doesn't gel. It really ticks me. We should do better. And we see that we are so rich in natural resources, but we can't even produce. I mean, we produce cocoa, but we don't have chocolate factory here. We produce crude palm oil, but we don't have the perfume industries or the soap industries to support that. So we are just exporting of raw materials without being able to process it. Now that ticks me, and I think going 3 or 5 years ahead, Indonesia must be able to generate that expertise.
Corruption is still a major problem here in Indonesia. Do you think enough is being done to stamp it out?
I think the government is really on the right track now, moving at on the right in the right directions, but the speed or the pace, people wanted to see more. I'm from the business community, and I can tell you that there's some change. There are a lot of awareness of this, but there are still cases, and how you differentiate cases from a systemic issues. You fix the systems, cases will always be there, but the systems, you got to fix it.
Some would say that only a select few are actually benefiting from the resources boom, that the profits are not being distributed fairly, considering the tens of millions of Indonesians still living below the poverty line.
Spot on, and I think you hit the nail on its head. Basically, if we're not careful, the rich will get richer, the poor will get poorer, and this gap will be the embryo of the next unrest. So as businessmen, as entrepreneurs, we need to make sure that the wealth is spread more equally, and therefore an equitable growth strategy, an inclusive one that includes the people. And that's why I spend a lot of time on empowering the micro, small, and medium enterprises, the micro entrepreneurs who basically define Indonesia's domestic demand. Why consumer goods products sells very, very well in Indonesia? Because we have a resilient micro, small, medium enterprises space that would able that has been able to pretty much absorb all these products.